The Mindset Presentation by Johannes Stockburger. Today I am talking about the following questions. What is the mindset? Why is the mindset important? How to manage the mindset and why is that so difficult? But how do we succeed anyway? This presentation takes around 25 minutes. After the end, we have time for your remarks and questions. I will not record this webinar. I have already a recording from the presentation. In the Q&A, I want us all to talk openly and freely. Therefore, I will not record the discussion. Before we start, I want to state this with clarity. I am not a therapist and I do not provide therapy. The purpose of this webinar is education. I want to help you understand the concept of a mindset and its importance. I will show you also some methods and techniques helping you to nurture and grow a strong mindset driven by positive energy. We know medicine and food. The task of medicine is supporting a sick body, while nutrition has a purpose of keeping a body healthy and full of energy. This presentation and the Mindset webinar are food for your mind. Thank you for attending this webinar. We will dig today a bit deeper into the meaning of the term mindset and into the power of that concept. By the end, I will show you how a technique can tweak your mindset and how you can get rid of some habits that do not serve you very well. But first, a few words about myself. In my early days online, I bought an audio course from a lady called Lisa Dian, teaching online marketing. The name of her course was The 6M Method. Most of its content was clear-cut and easy to understand, but there was one M giving me headache, the mindset. I understood the importance of a mindset. But unfortunately, I felt my mindset was wanting, without an idea how to improve that. Therefore, I felt damned to live the life of a loser. But as a never-give-up person, I did not accept that verdict and learned instead how to manage my mindset. This skill gives me more freedom than money can buy. I'm going to share part of this skill set today with you. My name is Johannes Stockburger. I am the creator of the Love Plan for Success and Inner Growth. Some of you may already know me, but this is still the right place for a few sentences about myself. I grew up in post-World War II Germany. At the age of 12, I lose trust in my parents. My father is a pastor and I get him flagrantly lying in the church. He denies in the church that we are going to move to another town. But in truth, my parents travel the same afternoon to that new place and close the deal for the new post. A few days later, I find that out by secretly reading a letter from my grandfather to my parents. This turns me into a boy with a broken relationship to his parents. Most of his remaining relationships vanish also because he moves with his parents 100 kilometers away. Therefore, I started at the age of 12 to think about the meaning of the word truth. I asked myself how to determine what is true and what to dismiss. In fact, at that time, I was dreaming of becoming a truth teller. I wanted to put up a tent at fairs like a fortune teller. But instead of the future, I wanted to show my clients the truth of their present lives. As an old man, I am returning now to the dreams of that 12-year-old boy. But enough of that. Let's dive instead into the purpose of this meeting, understanding and harnessing the concept of the mindset. The definition of the mindset. We all have some automations in our thinkings and behaviors. We call them beliefs, habits, reflexes. They relate to one another, build on each other, and reinforce each other. Together, we build a system. We call this system the mindset. The origin of our mindset. Our mindset comes from several sources. Here are four of them: childhood experiences, excitement and fear, institutions with power, and peer pressure. The childhood. Experiences and impressions in the first years of our life have a huge impact on the way we structure our understanding of the world. They provide the anchor for our beliefs. We use patterns from our childhood experiences to create the fundamental structure of our mind. Later, we try to interpret and bend all information from our senses to fit into this structure. Joy and excitement. Experiences loaded with much energy have a potential to overwhelm our belief system. When perceptions of our senses are strong enough, our mindset cannot ignore or dismiss them anymore. Instead, the mindset must adapt accordingly. Fear and trauma. Some experiences come with a huge load of negative energy. They have an even stronger impact on our mindset. If we feel victimized and start to believe that this traumatic experience can happen to us again and again, it is difficult to get rid of the fear and focus on the better sides of life. Power, often organized by governments, but big organizations and families have also power structures. They connect undesired behaviors and thoughts to punishment. Whenever you come close to the limits we enforce, we apply a dose of punishment, both creating feelings of guilt and unworthiness for us who would like to explore the world behind that limits. While staying away from offenses get rewards and encouragements. Many schools are driven by this system, although the behavior we enforce may vary. Peer pressure. Few people enjoy standing alone, separated from a group. Therefore, demands of a peer group are often a reason for us to adapt a belief or habit. Of course, the feedback of our friends is important to us. We have all some blind spots and need the help of others to see things we would otherwise overlook. But what happens if a single one is right and all others around him are wrong and feel threatened by that insights of this lonely fool? Ask Galileo Galilei and Google him if he won't answer you directly. Mindset, the operation system for humans. Our mindset controls our lives in many ways, individually and collectively. The mindset is a finely balanced system consisting of our beliefs, emotions, behaviors, and habits. Because our brain belongs to our body, the body is also part of a mindset system. The way we move our body makes our emotional state visible. But our posture influences also our emotions and therefore our mindset. We must be cautious, attentive, and thoughtful when we try to modify our mindset. Small changes have big consequences. Self-awareness and incremental changes are key. Pauses allowing the results to play out are essential. The mindset and culture. I talk here about culture in a wider sense. Political and military strategists call that as soft power. Hollywood and Bollywood, TV controlled by governments, schools, religious institutions, corporations. We all strive to shape our mind according to their wishes and interests. But because those efforts are successful, people share basic structures of their mindset according to their religion and nationality. We call that shared mindset culture. The mindset and success. The mindset controls many aspects of our behavior, even without our awareness. This has huge implications. Behavior impacts not only focus, discipline, and the determination to succeed. It determines also what kind of friends we have and how much support we receive. Nurturing the mindset means keeping it healthy and growing. If we try to command our mindset, we fail. Changing a belief by stating that we changed that belief is impossible. It takes more. Neither can you change a habit through a single statement, nor can you delete information already present in your mind. But there is good news. We can change our beliefs and habits, and we can change the meaning of information we stored in our mind. We cannot undo our life, but we can amend it. There are 5 layers of support for our mindset. Number 1 is health. Number 2 are emotions. Number 3 are the habits. Number 4 is exposure. And number 5 is a rhythm of focusing and relaxing. Care for your body. Health is important. Our body is our most important asset in this life. This needs no further explanation. But our body is also the only channel we can use to funnel information from the world into our mind. Therefore, training, supporting and protecting our senses is a priority. Is it important that we keep training our senses throughout our lifetime? This means using them, exposing them to a wide variety of signals and protecting them from deafening and blinding signals like noise, laser beams, and screaming artificial smells and tastes. Listen to your senses. The biggest mistake you can make is trying to silence your senses, because they tell you things that you don't want to hear. Cigarettes, alcohol, painkillers and other drugs are such silencers. But remember this, body and mind are sensible. If you try to silence them, they stop talking to you. How to manage your energy. Our 5 senses are our interface to the material world. In the same way, our emotions connect us to the world of energy. We sense the energy around us, and then that energy resonates as emotions in our body. We expose our body to the energy of our environment. This is true for our home, our workspace, and all the small items around us. We reflect and transform energy. Very important are the people around us. They do not merely reflect energy. Humans are active energy sources. The stronger an energy source is, and the closer we are to it, the more it impacts our emotions. We determine through our posture and activities what kind of energy we allow to resonate with our life. Our body adapts to our dominant emotions and filters the energy of our environment, attracting and amplifying more of energy that resonates with our current emotional state. Therefore, we can change the energy we are taking in by sitting straight, standing straight, walking straight, even by just moving our body. How to manage habits. There are things we do again and again, day in and day out. Our alarm rings at a certain time in the morning. We get up, take a shower and brush the teeth. We do not take decisions before we perform those activities. Instead, we follow policies. Another term for those policies is habits. Those habits are part of our mindset. It is obvious how important sound policies and habits are for our life. Patterns of thinking. We all use recurring patterns of thinking. Another term for them is beliefs. Some are religious beliefs talking about the essence of life. But other beliefs are quite mundane, talking about ourselves, others, about money and society. Those beliefs are statements we have chosen not to question anymore. We take them as given. Of course, building and maintaining a belief system that serves us well is important. But modifying beliefs is tricky, because one small modification of a belief can invalidate many related beliefs. What do you stream to your mind? It is your choice where you spend your days and nights. The signals and energy your living space sends out depends on your actions and decisions. You design your home, switch the TV on or off. You have influence on your workplace, and you have at least the power to reject a work environment if it's too noisy or poisonous. It is your responsibility to determine to which kind of signals and energy you are willing to expose yourself. All the signals we allow into our brain and all the emotions our body experiences in response to the energy around us are saved forever in our subconscious mind. Our mind uses those data as reference body to evaluate and understand the data stream and energy it receives in every single moment. Having a sound subconscious mind allows us making better decisions fast. This is a game changer. We cannot delete information from our subconscious mind, but we can add data. And we have the power to re-evaluate information already existing in our mind with the help of our current data streams. This allows us to build context and modify the meaning of overly dominant or misleading spots in our subconscious mind. Therefore, we can improve our ability to make excellent decisions. Short, silent moments work wonders. Data stream coming from our senses and from our emotions concerning the material world and the energy world pass through several stations. The data move from the senses to the short-term memory. Our short-term memory passes them on to the entry area of a long-term memory. From there, the data move into a queue for crunching information. In the crunching process, our mind searches for known patterns and adds fresh information to the structures of our mind. This takes time and processing power. Our body performs most of that crunching while we sleep. If a flow of data in our mind is congested or blocked, we miss vital information. Under stress, we filter the input from our senses more than usually. Therefore, we see only the obvious. We hear only the screams. We switch the senses of smell, taste, and touch almost completely off. Automation takes over. If we want to develop a deep understanding of the world around us, we must avoid such stack overflows. Short breaks, especially after talking with other people and after finishing small tasks, help passing the complete content of our short-term memory into the data processing queue and wipe short-term memory clean for the next task. Sleeping long and deep creates an empty data queue for the next day with abundant space for the fresh information of the upcoming day. There are two steps you can take immediately. Keep your body straight and take regular breaks. Sit, stand and walk upright. This lady clearly did not start yesterday with taking care of her body and posture. But once she was a beginner. You do not need to buy a yoga mat to start taking care of your posture. Instead, observe your feet when walking. Make sure that they point to the same direction. Take regular breaks. Work fully focused for a relatively short period of 35 to 55 minutes. Then take a break of 5 minutes. Use these 5 minutes to relax, to stretch your body, and to empty your short-term memory. After the break, dive back with full focus into your work task. You have power to build your own life. My firm belief is we as humans have the power to transform our mindset and in the process our life and our personal world, regardless of past troubles or difficult environments. We are not bound by our past. Neither our own errors nor attacks or insults from our environment can constrain us today into a life that does not fit us anymore, if we do not allow such constraints. The past wields power over our future only as long as we remain connected to the energy of that past. 35 years ago, I was devastated. I was a political activist trying to prevent a nuclear war. And indeed, in 1987, we were not far from such a catastrophic event. God gave me the opportunity to help turning that situation around. But I paid a heavy price for it. I found out that I had been for years with the wrong people, who never took themselves seriously, nor had the will and courage to observe the world and accept that what they were seeing. The result, I ended up like a piece of wood spilled out by the ocean and left on the beach. But my calamity reignited the childhood experience we all share. We can achieve the impossible. We learned walking and talking, writing and reading. Toyota's slogan of 1985, "Nothing is impossible," expresses this experience perfectly. We can meet our life's challenges, learn our lessons, rebuild our body and mind. That memory helped me to fight it through, to build a new life from the ashes. In the process, I organized my experiences into a system. I call that system the Love Plan for Success and Inner Growth. 3 years ago, I presented my system to a coach. At that time, my working title for the project was Success and Inner Growth. Why Success and Inner Growth? I want success, but I am not willing to pay for that success by ignoring my soul's reasons to send me into this life. Ignoring the needs and wishes of a soul leads directly into a joyless life marked by burnout and disease. My coach noted, this is a love project. I did not understand that immediately, but it's true. The Love Plan for Success and Inner Growth maps out a path where we do not make a choice between success, self-love, and loving relationships with our family and friends. Instead, that system allows us to master the steepest challenges through the unlimited energy provided by our soul, combined with supported relationships with our family and network, based on mutual trust and care. I appreciate your time and attention. Thank you for following my presentation to the end. I have one question to you. Did you like it? Did you find it interesting? Please let me know and help others to find our content by pressing the like button. And subscribe to our channel. This way you will not miss our upcoming content. If you want to learn more about the topic, I'm here for you. Join us for the next edition of the Mindset webinar. After a short presentation, there is ample space for you, for your remarks and for your questions. Use the link in the comment section to register.